Welcome to our first pitch presentation featuring Jean-Paul Warmerdam, Global Engineering Manager at Moog. Discover how Moog's groundbreaking HMD motion compensation software eliminates motion sickness by precisely canceling motion cue's influence on image generation.
So HMD was mentioned, right? HMD stands for head mounted display, also referred as a VR headset. In this talk, I will refer to it as a VR headset for the ease of use. Such headset gives a whole new set of opportunities for drive evaluation, comfort shakers, and so on, compared to large dome projection systems. But it also comes with quite some new challenges. A VR headset has sensors to perform head tracking, but doesn't really know where it is every time in time and space. At Moog, we are aiming to deliver the best motion quality and experience. We deliver motion bases and force feedback systems as standard products, but also dedicated fit for purpose drive simulators and comfort evaluation shakers. So let's talk about the compensation and take a scenario to discuss what is really happening if you're wearing such a headset on top of a motion base. So in this scenario, you can see a driver is sitting on a motion base looking straight ahead. His expectation is that he sees the horizon straight for him, in front of him. So now on the right side, you can see this driver wants to accelerate. And to give him an input cue, a sense of, say, acceleration, we will tilt the platform backwards, so he will feel a sustainable cue in his back. Now you can see his head didn't move to compare to the local coordinate system. So he's expecting to see the image, as you can see there on the top right, that the horizon is still mid-screen. But as you also can see, the headset has an angle now, so it will detect that angle. And if you do not compensate for that, you will get the wrong image, as you can see here with the red cross. So let's test this and see how that works out. So here you can see a test setup at Moog, and we have a very rigid employee fixed to a motion base. He has been sitting there for quite some hours, so we could test. You can see the VR headset is rigidly mounted to his head, and the body is restrained to the motion base. And this gives us the opportunity to inject in a very controlled way several movements. And as you can see in the graph, we subjected, in this case, three sine waves of pitch, roll, and yaw. And when you disable the compensation, you can see the signals that are detected by the headset that are typically used then to provide to generate the image generation. When you see we enable the compensation algorithm, those signals are completely reduced to the minimum. And these values are way better than the EASA is now currently specifying for full flight simulators. So once we have tested it, we also put it in a real test in this setup where you can see me flying a helicopter in this case. The image that you're seeing there is the image that I see in the VR headset. And as you can see in the two boxes, the red and the green one, there's a slight difference in what the graphical representation is. Obviously, on the left side is wrong. And can you imagine what this will do if you gave such a false cue to a pilot or a driver? Simulator sickness is really at stake here. So those compensation algorithms that we have developed are possible because we know exactly in time and space where the motion base is and also where the driver is. And with that data, we can then calculate with high precision and low latency what need to be compensated before those signals are being provided to the viewport of the image generator. We think it's absolutely vital to compensate for those movements. And that compensation software is available on motion systems for Moog. And I invite you to come to see us to talk and discuss the options for your applications. Thank you.